From the beginning of time, it was essential to life. In the primordial soup of early Earth, it served as the chemical backbone to the first compounds that eventually became life itself. Phosphorus, the 15th element in the periodic table. It's unique in its sticky chemical nature. Phosphorus has historic and scientific importance. It's the first element isolated and discovered by modern science. It's part of our bodies. It's in our skin. It's in our bones. It's in our cells. It's in our genes, our DNA. Phosphorus even provides the most fundamental form of energy storage. It's like a rechargeable chemical battery for life. Not only is phosphorus in every cell of humankind, it's critical to the growth of the crops and the livestock that feed us. We are all dependent on it. So what's the problem? Phosphorus is a finite resource. It comes from the Earth. Although humans are spread across the globe, phosphorus is not. It is unequally distributed. The great reserves can be found in places like the southeastern US and Morocco. Today, giant mines provide the majority of the world's phosphorus, moving the nutrient from massive deposits to areas of deficit. Visit Walt Disney World in Central Florida, and you'll fly over the great phosphate mines of the US. From there, phosphorus is shipped all over the United States and all over the world. Phosphorus is used everywhere. It adds the sharp bite into colas, makes fire retardants work, helps bread to rise, lights matches, might even be found in your television. But unlike other scarce non-renewable resources like fossil fuels, phosphorus doesn't always get the attention you might expect. And so, we come to the phosphorus paradox. Too little phosphorus undermines the food security of nations and the development of continents. Too much phosphorus creates one of the most extensive, intractable water quality problems on the planet. When trace amounts of phosphorus unintentionally run off the land and enter a water body, algae growth can become a major problem. Phosphorus in water can upend entire ecosystems, destroy fisheries, and even create vast dead zones. We all contribute, both to the demand and the environmental problems associated with phosphorus. But most of us have no idea how important it is to us, or how we fit in. As we go about our days, we make little decisions that, in aggregate, drive major outcomes in how phosphorus is used. These decisions, from the food we eat to the prices we demand, cause unintended consequences. Modern agriculture has brought fertilizers containing phosphorus, along with other inputs, to grow crops to feed an increasing world population. And all the while, we're depleting our high-quality phosphorus sources, upon which we've built our food production systems, and arguably, our societies. The US, once a major exporter of phosphorus, will soon be a net importer. Our options for new sources within the United States are limited. And other sources that we might turn to aren't so clean. They contain cadmium. They contain uranium. And it takes a lot of energy and money to remove these contaminants from the phosphate rock before it can be safely used. So, what can we do about it? In the developing world, researchers are helping farmers select crops whose roots grow in places where only scant supplies of phosphorus can be found. In the developed world, conservationists are devising watershed programs that stop phosphorus at the source of application before it enters waterways. Can we be smarter about the way we use phosphorus? Sure we can. We can more efficiently use the phosphorus that we have. We can better recycle phosphorus between our cities and our farms, and we can capture phosphorus before it's washed away. But doing this involves change in how we grow food and what we eat, how we treat our sewage waste, how we use fertilizers, and how we manage our landscapes. Clearly, this is complicated. Awareness is key in recognizing our own role in the problem. We can learn a lot from critical stories shared by scientists and politicians, farmers, fishermen, and miners, about successes and failures, about hope and frustration, about the known and the unknown. How often do you get a chance to make a difference in the story of mankind? The time is now. The phosphorus paradox is an urgent problem, and it's a story we are compelled to tell.